What is going on, guys? It's your boy DFastX, and I'm back with another movie review, and this is my review on Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. Before we get into the video, if you're here to see more of my exciting videos, if you're new to the channel, smash the subscribe button, click the bell icon, and drop the likes. So I finally got to see this movie, and I honestly got to say, I absolutely enjoyed Multiverse of Madness. This was a good movie. But in my opinion, it would be the best one that I've ever seen in my life. But it was a pretty good, it was a really good movie overall. Guys, this movie was really good. I actually enjoyed this movie. But I felt like that it wouldn't be like the best one that I've ever seen. So where the story takes place? This takes place, apparently I heard that this takes place 2 months after Spider-Man No Way Home. Where after Peter Parker messed up the spell and brought every villain from previous Spider-Man movies into his universe as well. So this is kind of the continuation after this, where Stephen Strange, he's having these nightmares of this person in his head. And apparently, there's other variants of Doctor Strange in his head as well. But story goes on with Doctor Strange having these nightmares and stuff, and, you know, trying to fix this multiverse problem and stuff, with this helping person called America Chavez, played by, I think it's Jogi Exotic Gomez, if I'm pronouncing her name right or anything, but she plays America Chavez in this, and she was amazing in this movie. She was pretty cool in this movie, because America Chavez's character, she could travel through the multiverse, she could travel through every universe where she can be safe and stuff and all. And so she ends up in Stephen Strange's universe and try asking for help to kind of fix this multiverse problem and stuff. And so story continues on then with Stephen Strange, America Chavez, and Wong trying to get some help with a person in, with the whole multiverse situation. So Stephen Strange decides to go and visit Wanda Maximoff, played by the one and only Elizabeth Olsen. And I gotta say, her performance in that movie was just excellent. When I watched that movie, I just cannot believe how much Elizabeth Olsen's character as the Scarlet Witch has changed. When you watch this movie, her character has completely changed from Avengers Age of Ultron, Civil War, Infinity War, Endgame, and after the events of WandaVision. She is totally changed. And like she kind of turns against Doctor Strange, and she kind of goes her own way and stuff, because if you have not watched WandaVision yet, you have to kind of watch what the story is all about. The story then, because it continues on with Wanda, ends up being the main villain of the movie, and she turns against Doctor Strange, Wong, and wants to get America Chavez's power away from her, like, so she can see her kids again, because apparently she sees her kids in her own head or something, in every universe she sees. And now the scenes, I gotta say, there was a scene where the Doctor Strange and America Chavez go through every universe, but it goes really fast. Like, you have to kind of like, you kind of have to like catch as it goes. Like, it's really, really fast and stuff. And like the director of this movie is Sam Raimi, who directed the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man movies back then, and other films as well. I gotta say, it was the action and visuals were really, really good. I thought they were actually really, really good. You know, with the kind of like universes and, you know, all these monsters and creatures. All the visuals and CGI were really, really good in this movie. Now, I gotta say, the acting in this movie was okay. I wouldn't say it'd be really bad at all. It's just that the acting was kind of in and out a bit of stuff, and even with the story, the story was a tiny bit out of where the whole story was going. It was kind of a bit lost to stuff a bit, and with all these with all these kind of like multiverse, with all these multiverse creatures and villains and the whole universes and all those kind of plot twists and stuff. But overall, it is a really good movie. It's really good. Now, in my opinion, I kind of wanted more in this movie. I kind of felt like the 2 hours and 6 minutes, it should have been longer than that. Like, I really think that Doctor Strange in the Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness should be longer, because there's so much more I wanted to see. And like, there's barely cameos that I wanted to see in the two, like. And like, it's a pity that we couldn't get, I it's a pity that it couldn't do that. I wish that this movie was longer. Like, I really wish, I'm just saying in my opinion, it should be like 2 hours and like 35 or 40 minutes. It should be that long than just 2 hours, 6 minutes. Because there's so much more I wanted to see in this movie. I really wanted to see more. And it shocks me to see that, like, for a movie that is gets where people gets this hyped, it's just that people myself want to see more of this movie than movie, because it's the whole what we want to see all these cameos from previous movies, like we saw from No Way Home and stuff. But it's what I gotta say, it is a good movie. And actually, in fairness, I actually enjoyed it. It's just that I wish it was longer and stuff. But story continues on still with Stephen Strange tries to fight back Wanda, and she apparently, I'm not gonna tell you the ending, but the ending will kind of leave you questions. What exactly happened when you see this movie at the end? But then the post-credit scenes then. There's one post-credit scene that it kind of leaves you into, I'm not sure it will lead to the next Doctor Strange film or something, but you have to see what I'm talking about and stuff, because there's a particular character that appears in one of the post-credit scenes. But overall, guys, I absolutely enjoyed Multiverse of Madness. I just wish that the movie was longer, and I wouldn't particularly say it'd be one of the best Marvel movies that I've ever seen, but I actually enjoyed the movie. It was great. It was a really good movie. But overall, guys, I'm giving it a 7 out of 10 and 4 stars. Guys, it's in cinemas right now if you want to go watch it. It's worth to watch anyway. It's now, as I said, it's a really short, it's 2 hours, 6 minutes. I really think it should be longer than that. But go enjoy if you're going to see it today or this weekend. Just have a good time watching it. So that is my review of Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. The next one I'll be going seeing is the upcoming movie in June, Jurassic World Dominion. So stay tuned for more of my video, guys. Smash that subscribe button, click the bell icon, drop the likes, and I'll see you all next time. Peace.